This is Bro's Death, and it is January 21st, 2015. And today's report or thought is titled, Where Has All the Love Gone? As many of you know, recently, my wife, Carlin, had a really bad accident where she slipped on black ice and severely hurt her knee. And she has, until just very recently, since January 1st, has been unable to walk on that knee. And as you can imagine, it has put a lot of strain on our household because I've had to pick up all the pieces, and I've had to take care of her and take care of the house and do everything on my own. Now, I'm not complaining. It's my joy to be able to help my wife. And I find a lot of pleasure in being able to help and serve her. Well, in the course of that, what happened is my back went out on me because of having to help her get around and take care of some daily functions that she needed to take care of. It became, you know, it became a little difficult. And the older you get, the harder it is to manage these kinds of things. And now I know why people hire in nurses or hire in home health care workers, because it can take a toll on you and to all of you who are in that predicament. My heart does go out to you. It gave me a whole new perspective on what some people are suffering with on a daily basis. So I asked the question, where has all the love gone? And here's where the reason I'm bringing all this up, I'm driving to a specific point. Let's turn to the scripture. And let me read a few things here. John 15:12, this is my commandment, that you love one another as I've loved you. John 15:17, these things I command you, that you love one another. Romans 12:10, be kindly affectionate to one another with brotherly love, in honoring, giving preference to one another. Romans 13:8, owe no one anything except to love one another, for he who loves another, basically that goes on to say, has the love of God in him. And then Galatians 15:13, do not use your liberty as an opportunity for the flesh, but through love, serve one another. And the scripture goes on and on. I did a word search, love one another, and it's amazing what's there in the scripture. And so we can see clearly from the Bible that we're called to love one another, and God expects us to show our brothers and sisters that we love them. Not to just mouth the words, but to live out the actions of love toward one another. Now, we go to a really large church, and my wife helps out in the hospitality and has been doing it for quite some time. And the people in the hospitality part of our church knew that Carlin was laid up because of her knee injury. And only one person that we know, and I'm not going to name names. Well, in fact, I will. I'll tell you, Glenn and Gloria, which are friends of ours who used to go to that church with us, they came by, Gloria came by and brought us some Taco Bell and gave me a night off from cooking and having, and you know, and spent some time with us, and it was the nicest thing in the world. And I'm thinking, we go to a church with a couple thousand people in it, and no one from this church has reached out to us. And I hope this doesn't come across as self-serving. I'm not trying to make it sound that way, but I think that what's happened to Carlin and I and our experience in the church today is indicative of what's going on all over the world right now. And that is that we have stopped showing one another that we care and love for one another. Oh, it's easy to say, I'll pray for you. It's easy to say, let me know if you need something. And that gets everybody off the hook. But it's as though no one wants to stop the miracle round in their life and take a moment and think about what they can do to help somebody else. I mean, back in the 60s and 70s, here's what happened in a congregation. When someone was sick or laid up, like my wife was, you'd get a knock at the door. They don't even call and ask when they can come by. You get a knock at the door, and there are three senior citizen ladies of the congregation there. And one's got a casserole, the other has a pie, and the other one brought, you know, maybe mashed potatoes or green beans, something like that, whatever. And they just say, hi, we're here to help out. And they come into your house and they go to the kitchen table. They put everything down. They say, come on and eat. Take the night off. That's what they used to do back then. They didn't tell you they loved you as much as they showed it. And today we're caught up into this technology's keeping us so busy and so preoccupied and so consumed. We just got so much going on around us that we're failing, all of us are failing to exercise the greatest of all commands that our Lord gave us, to love one another. That was his heart cry. And love is an action. It's a verb. It's not passive. Love is aggressive in that it seeks out people to touch and to help. And it's emptying ourselves of what's important to us at the moment and to put someone else in front of ourselves. I just wanted to share this with you. It's something that was on my mind and my heart based on personal experience. Look, I gave you the scriptures early on in this message. We are expected by God, myself included, to love one another, just like Jesus loved us. So let's try as a group of believers in Yeshua to set a standard in 2015, to be people that act out our love and not people who just talk about it. This is Bro Steph. I'll talk to you again soon. Remember, you can visit our blog, our intelligence blog at brosteph.org. Our audio blog is audioboom.com/brosteph. And join our Facebook conversation. We got well over 900 people that are part of our online family that have discussions every day. That's at facebook.com/groups/brosteph. Remember to live out your faith and love one another like Christ has loved us. I'll talk to you again soon. God bless you.